Hi guys, welcome back to the Big Sew Along. I'm Ginny, and as always, I thank you so much for stopping by to spend a little time with me. I really appreciate it. Today, we have a couple of things to talk about, but as usual, I'll just start off with some of my comments from last week's video. Last week we did the Pinafore, and I had a ton of comments on that, so thank you all so very much for those. One of the comments on that, which wasn't really like about that pattern, but Charlotte actually left me a nice long message about that video, and at the end of which she alerted me to the fact that Folkwear Patterns has what? Basics. Folkwear Basics. They have, I want to say, I can't remember now if it's 4 or 5 patterns. If you guys haven't seen those already, you should go check them out, and I will leave a link to those below. One of them is a pinafore, and it's pretty cute. What else? Toby suggested that I do a video on where I like to shop for my fabrics online. I talk pretty regularly about the places where I do shop, but I can totally do a video, a roundup of where I shop online and what kind of fabrics I like to get at those places. And so I will try to get that together for you guys sometime in the near future. Lynn over on Instagram, this is super cool, left me a message the other day about something called StitchCamp from textileartist.com, and I'll leave a link to this below. Again, Stitch Camp is I think it's 5 days, but it might be 7 days, workshop for textile artists, and they're going over things like printing and painting and stitching. I apologize, you guys, I cannot remember the featured artist's name, but the first day of the camp was today. It's free. I'm not gonna say that. It's free. You just like sign up on the email and they send you a link to each video. So I'm recording this on Martin Luther King Jr. Day, which is Monday. You guys will see it on Tuesday. The Stitch Camp started today on Monday. So hopefully, I'm going to leave a link to it. So if anybody's interested, hopefully you'll still be able to sign up and just catch up with the old videos. I don't really know how that works. Yeah, I just hope you can, because so far, I just watched the introductory video, which was cool, and then I watched video 1, which was already just really interesting. It was only about 13 or 14 minutes long, and it was really inspiring, and I am really looking forward to, in fact, I went to the art supply store this afternoon because I wanted to buy more paint. So, Lynn, thank you so much for that link. As I said, I'm going to link it for you guys below, and I will also keep you up to date. I'll also update you guys next week and let you know how it goes and what I thought. The last thing is actually a comment not from last week, and in fact, I can't even remember when it was a comment from. I know Goat Girl asked me about this once, and somebody else asked me about this once. A while back, I did a video for, I think I was reviewing the cottage shirt from the sewing workshop, and in the video, in the pictures I did of that top, I'm wearing a pair of pants that I generally refer to as Japants. I have made the Japants a million times. All the dogs are coming down here now because I'm talking. Yeah, I've made those pants a bunch of times. I no longer have the first pair I made because I made it probably 2015, 2016, something like that. And anyways, I literally wore them until the fabric on the seat was threadbare, and I should have patched them, but I wasn't into patching then, so they turned into rags. Anyways, I wore a pair of my Japants in that video for the sewing workshop cottage shirt, I think it is. And I think that's when Goat Gal asked me what pants those were. I know somebody else has also asked me about those pants. So I'm going to show you a couple pictures here. I I haven't taken the pictures yet, so I'm just going to say I'll either show you two or three pairs of these pants, depending on how many I can find when I got to take the pictures. These are all old. I haven't made these pants for a couple of years, so these have been really well worn. One of them, I don't know if you'll be able to tell, the pockets are literally falling off. It's a really easy pant. There's no side seam. There's a crotch seam and an inner leg seam, and it's made for a drawstring waist, but you can also put an elastic waistband, which is what I usually do. There are no pockets in the pattern, but I always put like patch pockets on that. I have also made this pant out of a really like a mid-weight wool crepe, and it was really beautiful. I accidentally shrunk that because, as you guys know, I threw everything in the washer and not always in the dryer, but that pant did end up in the dryer, so there's a good reason to be more careful. Anyways, so I finally found a link to the pattern. It was from the Nanny Era website, which is Naomi Ito's design company, is Nanny Ero. And if you buy fabrics, you'll probably recognize her name. She does a lot of really beautiful fabrics, but also if you're a quilter, I think she really started out more like as fabrics for the quilting world. So Naomi Ito's website, and it was from 2000, and I can't remember if it was 2014. I think it was 2014. Anyways, I'm going to leave a link to this pattern below. All it is a one-page sheet with a graphic and a bunch of, and it gives you the dimensions to draft your pattern, and they're all in centimeters, so keep that in mind. It's a really simple pattern. It's easy to alter up or down if you need to. So I'll put that link to that, print it up, take a look at it. If you have any questions, let me know, and I will be happy to make a pair of those with you guys here on the Big Sew Along anytime. But I'm really super excited that I finally found that. It literally has taken me months to find the link to that. So there you go. Okay. I think that is it for comments and related things. I was going to make my Sew Liberated Arthur pants for this week, but I started this project and I really wanted to finish it. So that's what I ended up doing. This is actually a remake, and I can't remember if I showed you guys this original or not. This was originally a Diane Ericson River Tunic, and I did it last spring. This fabric is silk and cotton. It's really delicate and really, and I don't know if you can tell this print. I really love this fabric. It's super beautiful. But the issue is that I was just not wearing the river tunic. Like, I've had it for almost a year. I literally have not worn it once. I like it. I think it's beautiful. I just feel like it was one, I made that in a moment where I might have, I don't know, I was having some Downton Abbey fantasy about my life. I mean, my life isn't that. So I turned it into a slip. And yeah, I'm really happy with it. I probably, to be honest with you, probably like the original dress better, but I will wear this one more because it's just a slip and I can put a tank underneath it, or I can put a sweater over top it, and I'll wear it a lot more. I did do a quick tutorial here for you guys on how I made this, or how I turned my river tunic into this. I will say though, I just did this like on a whim, so the dimensions and stuff were sort of hit or miss. One of the things I did is in the tutorial, I think I say that the underarm goes down like 4 inches. This, you can see 4 inches to put my underarm 4 inches lower than the band here was probably too low. And this, it's not going to matter because I'm going to, like I said, I'm going to wear it like a slip. So I'll always probably have something over it, but I might also have something under it. But just be aware that if you're going to do this, if you're going to follow the tutorial, the dimensions for putting your arm, armhole measurement, it's really probably 2 inches, not 4 inches. Okay. Aside from that, the rest of the tutorial should be pretty good. So here you go. Okay, so my river tunic is inside out and it is folded together. So front sides up, backsides are together here. It doesn't really matter, just so you have an idea. So it's laid flat. Okay, so I know I tried this on, and I know I want the top of my slip to land right about here at the top of my flowers. So I am going to make a chalk line straight across here, like that. And then I'm going to draw a straight line from this, the closest edge, straight up to here. So our shape is kind of squared off. So 4 inches in from this line, I'm going to make a mark here. And then 4 inches down from this line, we're going to make a mark right here. Now, a lot of people, when they make this kind of a slip, will just cut this at an angle like that, which you can do. However, that means that your underarm is going to be a point, and that's really difficult to bind. So I prefer not to do it that way. Also, you're not getting rid of very much fabric right here, which is the front of your underarm, and sometimes that can come up too high and sort of like cut you in the underarm. So my answer to that is to use my curved ruler and cut it like that. Now I want this to be straight for like half an inch right there, and I'm going to say half an inch right here too for our seam allowance. The rest can be curved. So you have something that looks like that. And now we're just going to cut that out. And I'm cutting through 4 pieces of fabric, 2 fronts and 2 backs here. Well, actually 1 front and 1 back, but they're sewn together. I mean, they're folded together. You know what I mean. Perfect. I'm gonna put a little notch right here in the center front and center back. Okay, now I'm just gonna move this aside. Actually, we're gonna take our front measurement, which is from bra strap to bra strap. On me, it's 11 inches. We need a half an inch of a seam allowance on either side of that, so we actually need pieces of fabric that are 12 inches. And we want them to be 2 inches wide, and we need 4 of them. So, I'm gonna cut right on this grid. So mine needs to be 12 inches long, which is right here. Now my fabric here is double layered, so I need to cut twice, 2 inches twice. I'm gonna cut right here. And these are going to be our little sort of front and back yoke pieces. Now the rest, so we should have 4 of these, 2 of each. Now the rest of this sleeve piece we're going to use for our straps. So you can go ahead and cut them now, or you can wait and see exactly how long you need them and then cut them. But we should have enough here to cut our straps. So the first thing we're going to do is we are going to take our slip and we're going to bind both of the armholes. If I can get this open. So we're gonna bind both of the armholes. That's one side, they both look the same. So we're just gonna bind from here to here. And then on both the front and the back, across the top, we're gonna run two rows of gathering stitches straight across the top. Okay, so I have bound both of my armholes. Not terribly evenly, you will notice. And I have two rows of gathering stitches here, and I know that I want this piece to be 11 inches when all is said and done, so I'm just gonna grab two threads and gather this up until it is 11 inches. Okay, once I have my gathers looking the way I want them to, I'm gonna take one of our 12 inch strips and I'm gonna place it right against this, the raw edge of my dress. I should have a half an inch on each side, so half an inch over here. And half an inch over here. And then we're just going to pin this on. Now I'm just gonna sew this on right across the top with a half an inch seam allowance, and then I'm gonna do the exact same thing to the back. All right guys, so here's the top of my slip, and you can see I have just put the band on there. There's the gathering, that's the, this is the back, and this side is the front. Not that it really matters because they're both the same. But I have, the only other thing I've done is press that seam allowance up in towards the band so it's nice and flat. And now the next thing we need to do is our straps. I have already made two straps and mine are finished. They're just, looks like just under 1 inch wide. And I just made them, I used the rest of my sleeve piece and I made them as long as I could. Yeah, so just under 1 inch wide. On my other two bands that we cut out before, I folded 1 inch under 3/8 of an inch on both of those. Those would be the facings for our top band. All right, so the first thing we're gonna do here is, I'm gonna put the straps on the back side first. And I'm doing that because once I get them on the back, I can try this on in front of the mirror and I can adjust them with the open end of the straps in the front, so I can adjust my straps and see exactly what I'm doing. So I'm gonna go ahead and put them on the back first. And I'm gonna line them up with the side edge of my armhole and the top edge of my band here, just like that. I'm just going to pin those in for now. And then same thing on this side. Actually cut that off. So like that. That's exactly the way we did our straps on our Pinafore last week, if you remember. All right, so once we get these on, we're gonna baste those in place just across the top. And then we're gonna put our facing piece on here. And we're gonna sew up here, across the top, and down the side. And just be sure that when you come down the sides, up the side and down the side, make sure you're not catching your strap in your stitching. You just want the strap to be caught up here at the top. Okay, that's our top back band pretty much finished. We're just gonna trim these corners. And once we have those trimmed, we're just gonna fold this to the back, pull our straps out like that. Now, on this edge, I am gonna understitch this edge here. And then I am going to try this on and figure out how long exactly my straps need to be. And once I do that, we're going to put the band on the front the exact same way. However, I think it's easiest if you do this inside out. So our straps are in here. Just make sure you don't twist your straps. This is the front, this is the back, and our strap is gonna go like this. It's gonna get pinned on here, and this one will get pinned on over here and basted, obviously. And then we're gonna do the exact same thing. We're just gonna put this piece on, we're gonna sew around the edges, and then we're gonna turn it to the right side. Okay, so the last thing I'm gonna do here is just do a stitch in the ditch on both the back, right along the base of my band here at the top, and also on the front. And just be sure you're catching your facing on the underside. And that's it. Okay guys, that is it for me this week. I hope you enjoyed that. I hope it was informative. Please let me know what you think. Like, was it better before, the better after? I don't know. Like I said, I know what I'll wear it more now. So I'm actually really excited. And I haven't done this yet either, but hopefully right now you'll be seeing some pictures of me in this now. Okay, so next week, I'm shooting for the Arthur pants next week, you guys. I'm shooting for it. We'll see. I'm easily distracted. All right, guys, until then, thanks again for stopping by. Have a wonderful week. Happy sewing.